many times I just, you know, don't feel the inspiration to paint or do any other medium, but it's always healthy to do sketches. So that is something that I actually force myself to do. So this time I was on my studio and I knew I had some projects due, but I just did not have the energy and the creative juices to work on them. So I decided to work on this llama poses, and I did a few sketches freehand, and you can, you know, enjoy along with me while I'm doing this outlines. First, I started with the graphite pencil and on my sketchbook. So this one was with the intention to actually do an outline with some of those macro pens, and then probably scan them and play with the images digitally. Your sketchbook is full of potential, and I always encourage, you know, and invite any creative soul out there to get into the habit to carry a sketchbook with you. You never know what is gonna come out or when it is gonna come out. So carry multiple sizes. I have one pocket size that I have in my purse when I go out and, you know, run some errands, and then I have a couple different more sizes around the house, just laying there so I can open and they can receive in their pages the sketches, or sometimes just, you know, doodles and things like that, that they come into an idea. Many times they are just, you know, part of your brain, you know, just emptying, but other times, you know, you can create something neat with it. This will walk you through about the process of just me being sketching on this pages, and then the final product, and hopefully you can see the potential on your doodlings, and, you know, your any sketches that you have around, you know, they can become fun, especially when you start mixing the mediums, which is always fun. I did scan the pages after I outlined them. You will see at the end the final project, and I play with some filters and embossings and things like that, and lighting. So hopefully you enjoy the final results, and the process, and to get there is the fun part as well.
Thank you.
After I finish outlining it and then erasing all the graphite, carefully, I just brush off the debris and I hit it to my scanner. So I scan every single image of 350 resolution. So it's a pretty high resolution that I can manipulate the image in any ways that I want in future projects or so. So that way it's already a storage at a high resolution. So that's always a good habit also. If you have an image that you like and you know that you probably will use it for future projects, just scan it once at higher resolution. That way you can always bring it the resolution down, you know, for web purposes or promotion purposes. But it saves you time and energy. Well, after I'm done with the scanning, I did a couple twitches and played with the Photoshop program. So hopefully this one project will inspire you and, you know, get those images into a digital format and start playing and start mixing those mediums, those skills that you have. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe.